And we don't need any music. Well, should I tell you something funny that happened? One day the priest, he asked Muhammad, can I go to your church or your where you worship? He said, yes, go to the mosque with us. So they went. When the priest came back, we took him aside. We said, come here. What do they do? He said, what do you mean? They slaughter animals, they make bombs. What are they doing in there? He said, no. He said, they line up straight rows. They're real quiet. They stand like monks. And they're just standing quiet. It was probably Dohar Asr. They were quiet. They made no sound. All of a sudden, he said, they bowed, like in the Bible, it says they used to bow to their Lord. He said, then they prostrated, sujood, on the ground, with their head on the ground. He said, yes, they fell on their faces. This is what it says in the Bible. He said, I was amazed. He said, it was beautiful, beautiful. And so this was an opening for him, an opening. And then I said to him, okay, what kind of music did they have? He said, what? He said, they didn't have any music. I said, how are you going to worship God with no music? I'm thinking right away, that would kill my business. Since then, I've found something much better than music. To listen to the Quran in Tarawih in Ramadan is just brings my spirit up higher than it ever did with music. Because now it's you're hearing Allah's speech. And you're hearing some of these Qaris who have voices like angels. It's a wonderful experience. If anybody hasn't had a chance to listen to the Quran, they should open up their minds, their hearts, and their ears and listen to something much better than a piano or an organ.